received reports that the two lighthouse keepers from Oxford Point Island Lighthouse have vanished. The lighthouse keepers work.
You have one unheard message.
Two more lighthouse keepers headed
first unheard message.
On their arrival, they could not find.
Hi, baby. I'm stuck at the gate and they won't let me through. When you get back home, can you look for my ticket? I must have left them behind. Have a good look around and let me know. Love you. See you soon.
End of message. To delete this message,
anywhere. It looks like they were halfway through dinner when something interrupted them. There were no signs of a struggle, and all their belongings were still there, including a journal kept by one of them. The journal states several times that the island was talking to them. The most common theory is that the men have suffered from cabin fever and were perhaps accidentally washed out to sea. Other cases like this have been reported on in the past, but have never been fully resolved. A full investigation has begun into this bizarre case. We'll update you as the story progresses.
how clever our little girl is. I'm not sure exactly what's going on here, but she can already draw better than I can. She takes after her daddy. I'm stuck at the gate.
I got
and they won't let me
through.
It's not
just the two of us anymore.
Love you. See you soon.
hot off the presses. Tragedy has struck Pleasant Falls. A woman was found murdered in her home. She was brutally stabbed over 10 times. The victim's name was Sarah Pound. Sarah managed to make a call to 911 before she succumbed to her injuries. The primary suspect of this brutal murder is believed to be her husband, Gary Pound. He was found deceased only mere blocks away, slumped over the steering wheel of his car after a fatal collision with a tree. The murder weapon was found in the car with him, leading investigators to speculate that he crashed his car while fleeing the scene of the crime. The couple had a daughter believed to be 19 years of age, but police have been unsuccessful in tracking her down. If anyone knows the location, please contact Pleasant Falls PD immediately. It is also believed that Sarah is a victim to domestic abuse. If you or someone you know is suffering from domestic abuse, get help before it's too late. Listen up. We've got some news hot off the presses. Tragedy has struck Pleasant Falls. A woman was found murdered in her home. She was brutally stabbed over 10 times. The victim's name was Sarah Powell. Sarah managed to make a call to 911 before she succumbed to her injuries. The primary suspect of this brutal murder is believed to be her husband, Gary Pound. He was found deceased only mere blocks away, slumped over the steering wheel of his car after a fatal collision with a tree. The murder weapon was found in the car with him, leading investigators to speculate that he crashed his car while fleeing the scene of the crime. The couple had a daughter believed to be 19 years of age, but police have been unsuccessful.
June 6, 1999. My hands are shaking as I write this. Maggie's gone. Michael's gone. And Gary's gone too. At least the man I love is. It's just me and the monster living inside Gary. And the beatings are getting worse and I'm running out of excuses. I'm so tired. The lady next door came over yesterday. She must have heard something. She urged me to call the police, but I just can't do it. I love Gary so much. He's never gotten over Michael leaving us, and he blames me. And maybe it is my fault. All he does is drink, locked in that basement day and night reading those weird books. He's so unhinged now. What do I do? Can't abandon him. I know Gary's in there somewhere, and I'll be right here when he surfaces again. Fuck, this is so hard. I have to stay strong for him. June 6, 1999. My hands.
Thank you.
A woman was found murdered
was
in her home.
Stabbed over 10
managed
times.
Managed to make a call to 911. Had been victim
just
to domestic
me and
abuse.
The monster living in here does his drink.
Maybe it is my fault.
Yeah, abandon here.
Gary so much.
It's been 4 years. I need you and I love you more than I can express. Please, please get some help. They have a clinic and... No, please listen. Don't get angry. No, please. I'm not the one with problems. I just need to numb the pain. It's the only thing I can do to not feel.
Welcome back to Cooking with Massimo. You have the ingredients to cook something truly special. Here we have some chicken been marinating overnight with some lemon. This liquid give it a really nice salty flavor. I want to tell you how to get this from your, but I think you know how I did. And next, we want
Now, you put it
in the pan, and you drown it, beer and a bourbon. It's a time for drinking now.
A spokesperson
you can
from
leave
the
it at a chicken and head out to
against
the
domestic violence had mentioned during the press statement that it's easy to turn a blind eye to domestic violence by explaining away the problem. Often in cases like these, the victim is in love with their assailant. As we all know, love...
Who the fuck are you? All you do is drink. You monster. I can't live like this anymore.
Семерка, четверка, единица, четверка, тройка, пятерка, семерка, четверка.
other news, the annual Orange Plum Festival is in full swing. Make sure you visit Main Street and some of the finest dishes our fine town has to offer.
I'm not the one with problems. I just need to numb the pain. It's the only thing I can do to not feel it.
easy to turn a blind eye to domestic violence.
All you do is drink.
Problem.
I need you, and I love you more than I can express. I don't understand how this happens. Sometimes he scares me. I just need to numb the pain.
Will suffer from addiction and sometimes deeper psychological problems.
told you I was sleeping. He was out with Maggie getting ice cream or something. I don't know. I was asleep. Look, my baby boy just died. And I don't know how. What kind of God would kill an innocent baby? I didn't kill my son. Yes, I had postnatal depression, but I'm...
An investigation has begun into the tragic death of a six-month-old baby boy. The father was out with their six-year-old daughter buying groceries. When they returned home, they found the mother of the child holding the infant in her arms. Authorities have taken the mother in for questioning, but she has since been released. A spokesperson for Pleasant Falls PD told us that the death has been ruled accidental. However, the investigation is ongoing. It's believed that faulty nursery equipment may have failed, causing this tragedy. InfoCare has issued a full recall on all their bassinets in accordance with the ongoing investigation. Our best wishes and condolences go out to the family involved in this tragedy. Investigation has begun into the tragic death of a six-month-old baby boy. The father was out with their six-year-old daughter buying groceries. When they returned home, they found the mother in her arms. Authorities have taken the mother in for questioning, but she has since been released. A spokesperson for Pleasant Falls PD told us that the death has been ruled accidental. However, the investigation is ongoing. It's believed that faulty nursery equipment may have failed. Investigation has begun into the tragic death of a six-month-old baby boy. The father was out with their six-year-old daughter buying groceries. When they returned home, they found the mother of the child holding the infant in her arms. Authorities have taken the mother in for questioning, but she has since been released.
find me on the baby monitor.
investigation has begun into the tragic death of a six-month-old baby boy.
Look, my baby boy just died. I had a strange feeling something was wrong. What kind of God would kill an innocent baby?
What kind of God would kill an innocent baby?
She has since been released. Our spokesperson was at Falls PD to receive the death.
January 11th, 1986. We just got back from the hospital with the latest addition to our family, little Michael, and he's perfect. Feeling a little strange though, almost depressed. I feel so guilty for feeling this way when it should be a time for celebration. Gary's been great, but he doesn't understand how I'm feeling. I tried to talk to him about it, but he just doesn't get it and tells me to be happy. He's right, but it's not that simple. Isn't it normal that I'm having postnatal depression with my second child when I didn't have it with my first? I'm depressed and happy at the same time. My God, this is confusing. I hope it passes. I know Gary will support me through this. I'm sure it's all going to be fine. The nurse suggested that I keep a journal to help work through my thoughts. So, here we go. Little Michael. I'm still not used to the name, but he's starting to grow on me. He's perfect, and he looks just like you. He's got your eyes. March 1985. He really surprised me this weekend. He blindfolded me and whisked me off in the car. When he took the blindfold off, I saw this horrible little rundown cabin in the woods. He'd purchased this place from an estate sale of a deceased hunter or something. He wants to fix it up so we'll have our own little romantic getaway. Maggie's staying with the neighbors for the weekend, so I guess I'll make the most of it. March 1985. He's like a changed man out here. At first I wasn't sure this place is creepy, but last night was simply amazing. Maybe this was a great idea. It just needs a woman's touch.
Thank you. Did you hear that? That's a drone.
The 5th March, 1985. I don't ever want to come back. Last night there were all kinds of strange noises. I could hear whispering. I think maybe some of the locals don't want us here. I heard something in the basement and had to investigate. Oh my god, it's the slaughterhouse down there with some really weird shit going on. I appreciate taxidermy as an art form, but this looked like more than that. And the cabins and the history and the strange noises. It'd be a cold day in hell before I set foot in here again. This is how those horror movies start. To see the bride before the wedding. Get out of here, you. slaughterhouse down there. It was some really weird shit going on.
Just needs a woman's touch.
A cold day.
It changed man out here.
Dear Diary, I haven't spoken to Dad in years. We avoid each other as much as possible. Dear Diary, I haven't spoken to Dad in years. We avoid each other as much as possible. He's always drinking and I'm scared to talk to him. Mom is a mess. She's so weak. I hate them both. I hate it here. I'm a prisoner in my own room. I can't have my friends over. I stay at Bridget's house as much as I can. It's time for a change. I met a boy 2 months ago. His name is Carl, and I think I love him. I told him about everything yesterday. My dead brother, drunk father, and drugged up mother. I thought he'd run for the hills, but he says he wants to save me. He says we should run away, and I think I will. What is my future here? I can't stay. I feel bad leaving my mom, but if she ever grew a spine, she'd have taken me away from here years ago. I have to go. Mom, I'm so sorry for everything that's happened to you. I can't do this anymore. Do you know how many times I hid under my bed listening to Dad hurting you? Falling asleep under the bed to the sound of you crying? I hate you for not taking me away from here years ago. I'm running away with my boyfriend, and I won't be coming back. I'd be safer living on the streets than I am here, and that's no way for me to live. I'm old enough now to understand that none of this is normal. Maybe we'll see each other again someday, but I never want to see him again. Get help, Mom. I do love you. Love always, Maggie.
April 1996. I hadn't spoken to him in what seemed like an eternity. So I was shocked when he asked me to come back to the cabin. I assumed he wanted to fix a marriage. Maybe try to move past everything and start over. Last time we were at the cabin, it was so romantic until the freak show started. And I vowed never to go back, but if I have a marriage, I'll try anything to win this. Once we got there, he just started babbling about this being the place of conception and rummaging through that fucked up basement. I don't know if I should be helping him or getting help. I want him to get help, but I'm scared of how he reacts.
June 6, 1996. Gary's gone totally insane. It's Michael. And he terrifies me. He terrifies Maggie too. I should have left with Maggie years ago. But I love him. And I can't just leave him like this. Maggie ran away. And she hates me for not standing up to him. She's right.
Some believe this is their life flashing before their eyes. Every action you take will bring you closer to your judgment.
Gary's gone totally insane. Maggie ran away. And she hates me for not standing up to him. She's right.
But now I'm all alone.
And I wish my little girl would come home.
But I love him.
And I can't just leave him like this. June 6, 1999. I'm in hell, and he's on his way there. I'm so weak, I can't even look at my own face in the mirror. The last time I did, I saw a twisted husk smiling back at me. I feel like his madness is rubbing off on me. So afraid of him that I slept under the bed last night. This needs to end, one way or another. Going to get us both some help tomorrow. I need to sort my life out and find...
Search grid has begun over the crash site, but no survivors have been.
So here he stands, at the gate. Does he understand the extent of his crimes against his eternal soul? He can't set things right. It's over. He can ensure eternity is fitting to those he affected. I'm letting it out here myself. Well, it's time to end it. Move on to the best part.
That concludes our broadcast today. Site, but no survivors have been.
So here he stands, at the gate. Does he understand the extent of his crimes? You finally arrived. I overestimated your comprehension skills. No matter, you finally get it. If you take your place, someone will be with you in